On this episode of Axe Night Suppers, I have discount ground meat. So I guess we're making meatloaf. So one night a week, Jules and I throw axes in the backyard axe throwing league. So we need something that's easy to cook, delicious, easy to eat, and will give us the fuel we need to win. These are Axe Night Suppers. So around our house, this is usually a bit of a cleanup recipe. I take whatever's left in the fridge from other stuff and stick it in a meatloaf. So for the one we're making today, this is what you'll need. Breadcrumbs, black pepper, pepper flake, chili powder, thyme, onion, mushrooms, garlic, bell pepper, red, green, yellow, whatever you have on hand. Ground beef, ground pork, although, you know, again, whatever you have on hand. Prosciutto, coarse salt, and an egg. So first things first, into the bowl that has the breadcrumbs, you want to put in pepper, hot pepper flakes, chili powder, and thyme, and just give that a stir. Then you move on to your other vegetables. So you take your bell pepper and you just give it a rough chop and stick that into a food processor. Do the same with your onion. Crush the garlic and peel it and then stick it in the food processor as well. And then I usually put in some kind of bacon because I like the flavor and also because it adds some fat. So much of the ground meat that you buy today is lean or extra lean. There's no fat, there's no flavor, there's nothing to hold it together, so I use bacon. But today I didn't have any bacon. I had a little piece of prosciutto, so I chopped that up and put that into the food processor. Now you want to put the food processor on until everything is finely chopped. You don't want it to turn into a paste. You just want a fine chop. Next step, really simple, just combine everything that you've already got. So scrape everything from the food processor into a big bowl. Pour in your breadcrumbs and then put in your ground meat. Today I'm using ground beef and ground pork because that's what was on sale. But use whatever you can get. You could mix it up. You could use pork, chicken, beef, lamb, veal. I don't know, what else? What else can you get that's ground? Stick it in there, crack the egg over top. And then you have to mix it by hand. And I know a lot of people are gonna write all kinds of comments about, ooh, he's not wearing gloves. You know, wash your hands before you start, wash your hands when you're finished, everything will be fine. Your hands are the best tool for the job, and wearing gloves doesn't necessarily mean that everything is clean. Once you've got it all mixed together, and this is a fine line because you wanna make sure that the breadcrumbs and the spices are evenly distributed, but you don't want to overmix it because then that makes everything tough. And it's one of those things that I'm going to figure out eventually. I haven't yet. Now you take a loaf pan and you put that mixture into the loaf pan, pat it in. And then flip that loaf pan over onto a baking tray that you put a piece of parchment on. It'll take a little bit to get it out of the pan, but the pan really is just to mold it into a shape. Now you stick that into a preheated oven and you let it go. At about the half hour mark, or you know, whenever I remember, I take some of our homemade ketchup or one of our homemade barbecue sauces and I just lightly brush or glaze that onto the top. And then stick it back in the oven for the rest of the cooking. Now you're gonna know it's done when an instant read thermometer, and you really should get one of these instant read thermometers, when an instant read thermometer reads 160 degrees Fahrenheit or 71 degrees Celsius internal temperature, it's done. Pull it out, serve it with whatever veg you want. Okay, it's not that pretty. It's meatloaf. Kinda looks like a disaster, but it tastes really good, trust me.